Yeah, we have seen how to process the data with Spark SQL. We also have to explore data frame operations so that we have better understanding about data frame operations. On top of APIs such as show to preview the data and insert into to save the data frame into Hive table, data frame also provide APIs such as select, filter, join, etc., which are nothing but alternative for typical select queries. Okay, so the same query which we are seeing here can be written using data frame operations. And there are a bunch of APIs which you should have idea about. You don't need to break your head around it as of now, unless you are not comfortable with SQL. So I will showcase some of those APIs with examples as part of this topic. That being said, let us continue on this DF itself, on this data frame. So let me run few queries here. So it starts with this, and let me copy paste these things. So we have this data frame. Let's copy this data frame name and then help paste this data frame and hit enter. You can see there are a bunch of APIs that are available on this data frame. Okay. We have ag. To aggregate such as sum, min, max, etc., whatever we have seen in traditional SQL. If you want to perform certain aggregations, you can use ag. And then you have count. You can get the you can apply count on the data frame, and you can get the number of records in the data frame. You can also describe. Let me show you. You can actually describe to see sample of data in a bit elaborate details. This typically you don't see it in traditional SQL. So describe on data frame will give you a bit of insights about your data. And you can use distinct to get the results, distinct records from the data frame. If you just want to drop a column from a data frame, and if you want to create a new data frame, you can use drop and pass the column name which you want to drop. And then some of the important ones is filter. So if you want to filter the data, you can use filter. I will showcase all those things as part of the demo once I give you a glance of different APIs which we have. Insert into, which we have seen already, where we can give the table name and it will try to insert the data in the data frame into a Hive table. Similarly, if you want to save into file format, there are APIs such as save and write. So there are two APIs to do so. Let me show you. Those are the ones which are very important. So let me go real quick into that and show you. So you have save, and you can give the path, and you also can give the mode. Modes are JSON, Avro, Parquet, etc. So whatever mode you want to save, data will be saved to that mode. Okay. And also there is an API called write. Let me show you write here. Write is an interface, and it have sub methods where you can actually save data in the data frame into a particular file format without specifying the mode. I will show that in a moment. And if you want to create RDD out of the data frame, you can use RDD API, and you can actually convert a data frame into RDD. Let me execute now. And also, let me show you help on write. Okay, so you can see write support JSON, where the data will be saved in the JSON file format in the path which we specify. With JSON, the mode will have, I think you can pass compression formats with mode. with APIs like JSON, etc. We also have ORC. So if you want to save the data in the ORC file format, you can use ORC. If you want to save the data in Parquet file format, you have Parquet, so on and so forth. Okay, it supports many typical file formats. Text, JSON, ORC, Parquet, Avro. If you have proper dependencies, it supports Avro. Avro is not supported out of the box, but if you know which package should be added and if you add that package, you can actually save it in the Avro format as well. As we have previewed the APIs, now let us use these APIs and try to see how the APIs can be used on this data frame. So this is the data frame name. If you want to get the schema of the data frame, you can actually say dot schema and it will give the schema details. However, if you want to get it in readable format, you have to use a function called print schema and it will actually give the schema in readable format. Okay. And now if you want to save this data, it's pretty straightforward. If it is table, you just have to use insert into and give hive table the way which we have seen earlier. On top of insert into, there is something called save as table as well. Okay. If you specify save as table and give the table name, it will actually create the table for you and it will load the data into it. So save as table is alternative for insert into. Insert into just inserts the data into the existing table, whereas save as table will actually create the table for you and then load the data. So you can use this data frame, and we have seen show. If you want to print certain number of rows from the data set, you can use show of 100. It will show 100 records. And then we will also use save. Save takes one mandatory parameter, which is nothing but path. And let me give the path as user D. Gadi Raju, daily revenue, save. And let's say I want to save in JSON format. I can specify JSON here. And then the data will be saved in JSON format. If you want to use write, you don't need to specify mode like this. You can delete the mode. Instead, you can actually say write.json and it will save it in the JSON format. Okay, so write is just a package which will provide you additional APIs such as JSON, Avro, Parquet, etc. Not Avro, but JSON, Parquet, ORC, etc. Okay, so here I will save it as write. And let me run this code. And also let me run this one. Okay, now let me query daily revenue write and also daily revenue save. And if you actually say Hadoop fs hyphen tail and then take this path and see the data will be in the JSON format. Same is the case with write. Okay, so there are two ways where you can actually write the data into files. It could be save, where it takes the path and mode. It could be write, where there are APIs such as JSON, Avro, Parquet, ORC, etc., which will take the path, and then you can actually pass additional details for compression and all those things. Okay. On top of this, if you want to use alternative way to SQL to perform data processing operations on the data, such as transformations using functions, it could be filtering the data, it could be joins, etc. They are also possible with data frames. So select is an API which is available, and you can specify the column names from which you want to get the data. In this case, let's say I want order date and daily revenue per product. I can run the query like this, or I can write the code like this and print the results. Okay, let us see the syntax. Okay, it's very straightforward. Just say help and paste it here and hit enter. I'm in the wrong window. I'm sorry. Help. Yeah, even I pasted the query in the wrong place. So let me quit and then paste this query in the right window. Now you can see the data. We got the date and daily revenue per product. Here it failed because we are not in the PySpark console. We are in the conch shell or bash. Okay. That being said, we got to the fields which we are looking for. If you want to get data only for 2013, July 26th, I can use filter, and here I can specify the field name like this, order date, and then triple equal to, I'm not sure whether triple equal to will work, but let's see. We will see the help and we will get the necessary support. Okay, 00.0. So you can specify almost all kinds of operators which we typically use. So there is a syntax issue. So the way you can actually get around is by using help and pass this to the help and hit enter. So the filter equal to operation is only double equal. Okay, it's not triple equal. In Scala, it's triple equal. That's why I got confused a bit here. And let me use double equal. And then let us say show. And you can see the data. You got only for 2013, July 25th. Let us change the date here. 26th. And you can see that you got only 2013 July 26 data. Okay, so like this, you have join, you have group by, and then you can use the aggregate in conjunction of group by. You have sort. You can do almost all the operations which you typically do in SQL. Okay, so this is about data frame operations, and that's it. We have learned how to perform data processing using Spark SQL. And we have used data frame operations to save the output into files, into tables. So this gives you a good overview about the Spark SQL, especially to give the certification with a lot more confidence.